Hey guys, if you've been watching my day in the life videos, you know that I have a pretty structured bedtime routine every night. I don't always show all of it, so I wanted to do a video showing all of it as I have been requested for that. So this is going to be that video. I have teamed up with Nature Made Kids First to share this with you guys. You know, our bedtime routine takes about an hour. I block out an hour for it every single night. So we head upstairs. I like to have lights out, eyes shutting at 8:30, otherwise I've got cranky children the next day, or if they stay up too late, it's hard for them to fall asleep, which makes no sense, but that's just the way they are. So we usually head upstairs at about 7:30 and start our bedtime routine at about 7:30. It is super structured and it's the same every single night, and I feel like it helps them. A lot of our bedtime routine focuses on like their wellness and their well-being, so you'll see a lot of that in there. A lot of it too is just the structure and the predictability of what's gonna happen, and I feel like it helps them get to bed. At least for sure it helps Drake, that structure and predictability. So okay, here's what we do. The first thing that we do when we get upstairs, and my kids look so forward to this because they taste so delicious, is take our vitamins. At this time of the night, like I said, this is very much, I wanna build up those immune systems. I mean, these are school age kids, touching and bleh. Anyways, the vitamin C that we like is the Nature Made Kids First gummies, and it's vitamin C. At this time of the night, I actually take mine as well. Tastes so good. We love the way that these taste. We've tried some other ones. They don't taste as good. These ones are absolutely fabulous. So we take these each night, and we do it before we brush our teeth, and we have a little bit of time to shower and stuff before. The next thing we do is one kid gets in the shower, and there's no rhyme or reason about which kid gets in the shower first. It's usually just whichever one can strip the fastest. So we have one kid that gets in the shower, and then the other kid goes with me to the closet to pick out their clothes for the next day. I lay them on the floor, we brush the non-showering kid's teeth, and then they switch. So now I have the clean kid out of the shower, we choose their clothes. I didn't show them this video because it's usually underwear or nudity. So we pick out their clothes and then brush their teeth, go potty, and now I've got two showered, clean children with their teeth brushed, clothes picked out for the next day. They've gone potty, which is important because nobody likes to wet the bed. And now we're actually ready to leave the bathroom and go into the bedroom. Once we are in the room and they've got their underwear on, they prefer to just sleep in undies even in the winter, but once they've got their underwear on or their pajamas, if they're gonna wear pajamas for some reason, then it's time to brush their hair. This kind of gives me a little bit of a jump start on the next day, especially with Drake's hair, because he can get some really crazy bedhead. Deacon's, meh, it's so short that there's really nothing I can do. I don't really brush it. So I brush Drake's hair, and then they start their reading. So they each have their own books that they have to read. Drake has, you know, some really cute repetitive kindergarten books, and Deacon is working on reading whichever chapter book he's reading that night. So we get about 20 minutes of reading in, and I will read with Drake, and then he'll read on his own, and Deacon just reads on his own. Now, if we have enough time, because it looks really simple in this video, right? You don't see the procrastinating or the kid who's in the shower, like discovering how to blow bubbles with the soap or filling all the bath toys or just crazy things. So there's usually a little bit of a delay there. But if we have extra time, then I will read something to them as well. While they're doing their independent reading, I am feeding and watering the birds. I am setting up their diffuser because, again, I'm just trying to pump up their immune systems the best as possible. Deacon has a really chapped face, so he has to apply a moisturizing face mask at night, which that sounds so luxurious, but he puts on his moisturizing face mask and chapstick if he needs it. Drake, if he happens to need anything, they both need lotion, and then I put various oils on the bottom of their feet depending on what they need. Again, just trying to keep my kids as healthy as possible. Once all of the reading is done, I turn on the fan if needed, and then I turn on their Death Star, which is, they're very particular about which color I leave it on. So I select the right color and then that's it, lights out. So this takes about a good hour. Now, of course, bedtime is constantly evolving. You know, it's definitely different now than it was a year ago. As they can do more on their own, it gets easier for me and they can get it done faster if they choose to, because, you know, kids. Like Deacon can brush his own teeth really well on his own now. I still brush Drake's teeth at night, not in the morning, but at night I do because he doesn't do that great of a job. So, you know, little things, the books that we are reading constantly are changing, things like that. But for the most part, this is exactly what we do every single night. every step of this gets done. It's not really optional. So it works out really well. I will leave information down below on the Nature Made Kids First Vitamins and the Nature Made Adult Gummies, both of them, the vitamin C, in the description box below. I get them at Target, $9.99, really affordable. They taste so good. They taste so good. I look forward to it. So anyways, I hope this helps you guys. I would love to hear what your bedtime routine is. Why is that so hard for me to say? I'd love to know what yours is down below. If there's anything that you see in our routine that could, you know, be mixed up a little bit, maybe better, I would love to hear it. But yeah, please share your bedtime routine down below. And I will talk to you guys very soon. Bye.